Can you speak to us? Why are you in this jail?
Just walking around here, it's like, you just get the feeling that you're being watched.
You wanna go down?
Ooh. No!
What was that?
It just goes, you wanna go that way.
You wanna go down?
Ooh. No!
What was that? Which way? 15.
Cell 15?
23 through 30.
What?
11 through 22.
Did something bad happen in this room?
Where should we go to talk to you?
Here.
Here?
Here, right here.
Okay.
Oh, it's weird in here.
Can we sit in your jail cell?
Let's try this. Turn this off. Now that we had it say in here, let's try sitting here and listening.
Okay. It's really quiet.
We should keep an eye on this place, I think, for the next couple days, on this specific area, to see if anything else comes through.
Now that we know that the noises from last night were coming from inside the jail, we're going to use the motion detector, vibration sensors, and LED proximity light panels to see if we can capture evidence of what was making those sounds.
Do you remember waking me up and making loud noises?
Can you take all of your energy, every little piece of energy that you have, and do something so outrageously loud that there's no doubt in our mind that you're here with us?
I heard that.
You could hear that, right?
Look, it's going off
right now. The vibration detector is going off. It keeps going off. None of us are moving.
During the day, we not only heard footsteps and movement through the third floor, especially on the west wing, but also the vibration sensor was going off. It was indicating that there was some sort of physical contact with the ground, so we know that something is happening there. Night one, we found the targeted areas. Now in night two, we're gonna kinda put our devices to the test and see if we can try to document a visual evidence of this thing that has been making the noises.
It's always a strange feeling coming back up here, especially at night.
Yeah.
This third floor has some serious energy. So that's why I wanted to bring the 3D mapping camera up here now to try to get a different perspective to see if we can maybe pinpoint where these knocks are coming from. But not only that, we can try to map out the figure that's doing it. We'll also have the thermal camera to try to capture any energy, heat signatures, cold signatures, and see if anything can move down this hallway.
And I think what's awesome about this is we know that that's what Ryan had good luck with, was the thermal camera. He has that amazing image. They saw it with their own eyes. So I think using the 3D mapping camera with the thermal, we'll be able to see, okay, does it have a heat signature? Or is it just showing up with 3D mapping, or does it show up on both? Sever, on this floor, can you walk towards us?
Where are you right now? Are you up here on the third floor?
It's quiet right now. It's strange, isn't it?
It's almost too quiet.
I'm gonna walk to the end of the hall.
Okay.
It's gonna not map me out, but just keep your eyes out.
Yep.
And let's see if I can draw it to you, Katrina.
Okay.
Can you make a loud noise so we can hear you? It's quiet back here.
Hello? She's like a breeze.
Let's go grab an audio device.
What?
I heard that.
What?
A jail door, one of these doors like shutting.
It's like a door closing.
Right.
I didn't even hear that.
That's what I heard. Let's go grab an audio device.
You guys heard this huge loud bang and it here shit. You were having footsteps rush up on you all last night. We weren't hearing all of it. It's funny to me that not, I mean, some experiences we're sharing and others seem to be focused on certain people.
Can you form and walk into this room?
We're on it. We're on the third floor. What side, east or west?
Is there a shadow man out here?
That's fucking terrifying.
It's like a scream.
I don't want to stay here. You don't have to be here. Did it just die?
I think so. Completely died.
What the fuck was that?
What's the matter?
What?
What's the matter, Rob?
Right here.
What?
There was like a whisper or something. Just right in there.
Rob hears a whisper in his left ear. Rob is a level-headed person, he's a rational person, and I can tell he's visibly shaken by his experience. Rob, what did the whisper sound like?
That was like a gasp.
Those are patterns that we keep having here. The moaning slash crying, the gasping for breath, the footsteps running up on you. I mean, those are all consistent with what we've been experiencing here.
I think we should listen back to what I just heard, because I swear I heard a whisper in my ear.
Yeah,
so I'm just gonna roll back. Let's take a listen.
Maybe it's audible. Maybe it said something that we can use.
Yeah. What the fuck is that? You guys have to look at this.
Did you get something?
Yeah, take a look.
But watch.
The fuck was that?
What's what?
What?
Oh, it
That's
moves.
Weird.
Yes, it moves. Holy shit.
What's the matter, Rob? Right here.
As we're listening back to see if we captured the whisper that Rob heard, there's actually something else that we're seeing that we didn't realize before. There is something moving on our cameras, and it looks like the outline of a shadow, and it kind of peeks out. It's very tall. It peeks out, and then it just goes back in.
We're seeing this thing that moves just slowly on the monitor. And what's creepy is it looks like this tall figure. What gets me is the height of it.
Yeah.
Because that thing is like 7 feet tall.
Which is consistent with what Ryan got too.
That's like higher almost than the door frame.
Watch it again.
I think we just documented this spirit of this inmate or whoever this thing is that is causing all this activity.